Yeah, it was definitely a lot different than my classes before, but I think it's a good change.
You can be independent and make your own choices.
It's cool because we get to interact with a bunch of other kids that we normally wouldn't interact with.
So we are tasked with the challenge of teaching the standard fourth and fifth grade curriculum that all kids across the district get. But then we also get the opportunity to enrich the curriculum, go further with the science and math and technology.
We still are teaching district curriculum as a whole. We're still teaching fourth grade math and fifth grade math. We're teaching all the social studies and science that we would normally teach in the district. What's a little bit different with that is that we may spend more time with like the science units and go a little bit deeper.
You focus more on science and technology, that's for sure.
We love technology and love to do things with technology, but we want to incorporate it in ways that are genuine and actually enhance learning and not detract from it. So it's not just coming in and getting to play with drones and playing with fun things that we do have access to, but we really want to use it to teach and to help students learn.
We have 50 students that we share between the two of us and between two classrooms. 25 of those students are fourth graders and 25 of those students are fifth graders. And so we cycle through with our students each year, so they'll stay with us for 2 years and eventually become our fifth graders. And I think that's kind of the core of what's really unique is we have this multi-age classroom where we have students being leaders and we have students learning from each other. We have a variety of groupings where students are sometimes working with students of their own grade level and sometimes working with students from other grade levels. And it's just a lot of moving parts and moving around and trying out different types of groups of people.
We plan our curriculum over a two-year cycle because we expect kids to stay with us over the 2 years.
Yep.
So 1 year in our program, we focus on fourth grade science and some social studies, and the next year we focus on fifth grade science and some social studies.
We have access to a lot of field trips, a lot of guest speakers, we do Skype in the classroom, and so we have that unique ability to get the kids sometimes out of the classroom. Mm-hmm.
It's like everything is hands-on, so you'll do a lot of projects.
Over the course of a day, a kid will be involved in reading, writing, math, science activities. Some of those activities will be whole group, all 50, 52 of us together for a mini lesson and then break out with book clubs. Some of the lessons will be 26 fourth graders doing math and 26 fifth graders doing math. And then what we really love is when we can mix the fourth and fifth graders to do partner work.
For fifth graders, it's really fun to like see the fourth graders grow and also to teach them like math. Sometimes they get stuck and you can go over and help them because you did it last year.
We often are giving kids kind of the tools and the resources and then allowing them to go out and research or explore or figure out what they can do with those things, whether that's an engineering project or a science project or even in social studies, even in reading and writing and, and math too.
It's a bit of a tough transition for fourth graders when they're coming in and it's a really big class, but I think it also empowers them to find their voice.
We really look for students that are risk takers. They are up for the challenge of being in a classroom with 52 students, both fourth and fifth grade students.
Also, you need to be very flexible because a lot of times things don't go the way it's planned. Like, we'll either extend something or we'll change something to do tomorrow.
The number one thing that the kids need to have is that level of independence and the ability to be willing to take risks. So today kids were off doing a whole bunch of different independent learning. They had to read the directions in the quest, kind of figure out what that meant, talk a lot with each other, really work on the collaboration piece of how do you work with someone else and how do you deal with different opinions.
And I think another thing that helps you be more successful in science tech so that it's less of a tricky transition is being someone who's excited about working with other people.
Someone who's able and willing to collaborate with others.
The ability to come with some organizational skills into science tech is really helpful.
Something like a skill you really need for getting into science tech is organization. Because both our teachers are very crazy about being organized.
When you first come into fourth grade, it's like a huge difference, and sometimes it can be stressful, but like the first trimester or so, you'll just have to get used to it kind of, and then the rest, you just learn a bunch and do a bunch of cool things.
It would really help if you're organized and like ready for a challenge.
And we don't expect that every, you know, fourth grader who walks in our door is going to be perfect at time management, perfect at organization, perfect at collaboration and teamwork and flexibility, but we want them to at least be willing to try those things.
The kids that have been successful and have loved the program have really wanted to be here from the start.
Make it a decision with your family and make sure your kiddo is invested in wanting to come.
And have that conversation and say, you know, are you willing to go to this brand new school? Are you willing to kind of start over and make new friends on that very first day?
It's important to think about, you know, it is going to be a big change, and is my child someone who is excited about joining a big group of people and maybe not knowing very many people?
And that's a challenging thing for some fourth graders who are really, really connected to their school or their neighborhood or their home.
I think that it'd be a good idea to ask questions because, yes, there are a lot of different changes in science tech.